Good morning, good morning, good morning. I am making my coffee because y'all, it's time. Also, my hair is in rollers because I actually have on a U-part wig right now, okay? I have not worn a U-part wig in probably like 5 years. And I'm so excited about this one because I ordered from a new company that I never ordered from, but the hair is really, really nice and really like matches my hair texture when it's straight. And so I basically just have, you know, a little bit out on the top. But yeah, I'm gonna show y'all what my actual hair looks in a minute because I'm excited to see what it looks like too. So yeah, let me get my life together, let me get situated, and then I'll be back.
And he's just going in on all the things that he's done. You know, no other god can say that they've done these things or can do these things. No other idol can say that. It's basically like for a few scriptures, God bragging on himself. Like, I did that. Mm-hmm. And then he says, I created you. I love you. Then goes into the things that he's not going to do because of his was disobedience. It was simply to say, like, God really loves us. He's really done so much for us. Even through the worshiping of idols, and, you know, we still do that today. It's not always an idol, meaning like a thing, mm-hmm. a little Buddha thing. It's like all the things that we put before him.
Right.
And he still loves us. But he sees that we're doing that. Like, imagine seeing that your children are deliberately disobeying you, but still blessing them.
Yeah.
They're telling you, I can do this myself. And with you knowing they can, you still decide to bless them.
Yeah.
Like, that's what he did then and now. Like, how's it? That's Old Testament. Like, he been.
What do you think of my hair? Isn't it pretty?
It is. Pretty. It looks like your hair.
I know. That's the point. I mean, it is a bit longer than my hair, but that's what I wanted. I wanted it to stay, like, looking like my hair, but not be my hair.
Mission accomplished.
Mission accomplished. But I am going to go over my roots up here a little bit. So I'm actually using my Dyson straightener real quick, which this iron has like technology in it. What are you yelling about? Oh, it's our daughter's birthday today. She's in New York. She turns 11. We wish we could have been with her today, but y'all know how it is when you're a blended family in 2020 and 2021 means that if you don't live in the same vicinity, it's hard to see each other with the lack of like travel being, you know, easy to deal with. It's hard, but you know, it's for a purpose, right? So I'm just like going over just the top one time. Cause last night I actually, to prep my hair for this, I didn't even blow it out or anything. My hair was really in a wash and go, okay? I had like my usual wash and go, and the wig came in the mail and I was like, oh, I'm gonna like do it right now. So usually I would have just done like my usual blowout process, like straight out the shower and then braided my hair up. But I was like, you know what, let's just see what happens. And it actually worked out well because I was able, since my hair was already dry, I just brushed my hair out and then I braided it underneath, which I'll show y'all how I braided my hair up underneath. This was honestly just like a test run because y'all know I don't do nothing to my hair that I don't also show y'all the process of. So don't worry, I will show you. I got this hair from Go Sleek, and so with my natural hair I just literally brushed it out, and actually I'll show you what I used. So on my hair and the wig itself, I used the IGK Good Behavior Spirulina Protein Smoothing Spray, this product right here. I think it's new, but it's a keratin like treatment in a can, 24-hour frizz control, 450-degree heat protection. So it does have dimethicone in it, so it does have silicone, but I'm not super pressed about silicones, like especially when I wear my hair straight. If I do want to go completely silicone-free, there are products out there, but I just wanted to try this and see how it worked, and I really like this product on my hair. And then I also used the Living Proof Instant Defrizzer on the wig because whenever I straightened it, it had a little bit of like flyaway, like static, and so this helped literally like lay that all down. So if you ever have like flyaways like up top, this specifically will help smooth everything down and keep it down. And then just for oil, because I can't not use like some sort of shine oil or whatever. I use the Olaplex number 7 bonding oil. If you haven't been using Olaplex, whether you're wearing your hair curly or wearing it straight, really, really good stuff, especially if you're doing multiple things, like you're coloring your hair and you're straightening and you're, you know, having fun, honestly. The bonders and things in these products really do help your hair bounce back. I usually use Olaplex at least once a week in some form, just because I do heat style, I color, you know, and I really don't color like that as much anymore as I used to, but I still like using the Olaplex products. They're just really good. So that's all I used on my hair for this style. And basically my plan is to keep this in for maybe like a week or so, see how it goes. It's really lightweight and I like it. When you have long hair and a lot of hair, it just takes a lot of time to do stuff. And so I'm really digging this. I'm digging this hair. And I actually left my ends out of the flexi rods to kind of give like a more of a wave vibe. And I think it did it. I think it gave me the look that I wanted. So Mark just told me something I didn't know, which was that once you hit 30, you can no longer shop at Urban Outfitters. Well, now we're gonna go to West Elm because
porno stuff.
Yes, we wanted to buy house things because Urban Outfitters online has cute home decor. So that's what I was looking for going in there.
So excited, y'all. We got some curtains, we got a bed, we got some like little like plates from West Elm.
2 hours.
But it was worth it. They had such cute things in there and we ended up getting things that we actually needed. But I will say, spending like $500 on curtains, like what? Why? I don't know. But
then you just say, oh, curtains left the room.
We need them. Yes, we need them. We need the we need curtains. That's why we had to bite the bullet and actually just get them and like stop whining about it. So,
well, since we didn't spend that much on curtains, we should have spent that much on curtains.
Yeah, right. Absolutely not.
Why not? What's the difference?
What do you mean? What's the difference between curtains and some Yeezys?
I can't wear curtains.
Your house is wearing the curtains. Like, the house is literally wearing the curtains 24/7.
Does the house work without curtains?
Do your feet work without Yeezys?
No.
No. Because that question doesn't need to be answered.
We know the answer.
No. But I'm really excited. The only thing though is our bed that we bought is gonna literally take 2 months to get here. And that's pretty much all the beds that we've found, like furniture in general. So now we're about to run into Target to grab some rods for our new curtains. And really spilled coffee. This is the new pistachio latte from Starbucks and it's really good. I got it with almond milk and it's very good. Like, I was surprised. But yeah, we about to roll up in Target, get these curtain rods.
Hallelujah! Clap your hands, hallelujah! Oh, she loves it. Whatever. Clap your hands for Jesus. Hallelujah! Woo! Hallelujah! Woo!
Cheese!
In there, baby.
I'm gonna take my phone. Everything she takes, she gonna take it and give it to T. I said, go get my phone from him. Oh, what was funny? My phone was in.
Sarai, put your diaper back on.
One, two, three. You know what I'm saying to me?